Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our 6th annual Youth Talent Show and the first ever virtual edition. We are coming to you live from Apex UMC. I am holed up in my office, and Dana Hall and I will be your host for the evening. Dana's over in the sanctuary, so we're going to be leading you through the evening. We also have Marcus McClellan here, who is doing all things technology, and he's the real brains behind this operation and making it work. So we are just delighted you're all here. I see you're already being active in the chat, which is awesome. That's what we want, because even though we can't be together tonight, we want to make sure that we're sharing this time well with each other. So you know, all of our talent acts have been pre-recorded. So we have 10 acts to share with you tonight. They've all been pre-recorded, and we're going to share those with you as the night goes on, along with some other fun things. So we hope you have your yummy meal with you, or if you're comfy on the couch in your PJs, whatever you may be wearing, that is great. And we're going to be excited for the evening together. Right, Dana?
That's right. We're so glad that you guys have taken the time to join us tonight. In a typical year, we'd be in the CLC, gathered around tables with friends, having a yummy dinner from Tzatziki's being served by several youth. And Greg Coley, our amazing host every year, would be leading us through the evening. So that's right, folks. You can add charming and entertaining hosts to the long list of things that COVID has stolen from you over the past year. And Greg, we hope you enjoy your year off, because next year we're handing this back over to you.
Amen to that. This is a one-year gig, Greg. Next year it's yours, man. Even though we've had to go virtual for this year's event, we are committed to making it as a fun and an interactive evening as possible. So that's why we have the chat going, this feature tonight, where you can be chatting. And as we get started, we'd love to hear from you. Most of you are already saying hello to us, which is great. We'd love to know, what are you eating tonight? Usually we have our tzatzikis ready to go, but since you can't have tzatzikis, or maybe you did, maybe you ordered in tzatzikis, that would have been awesome and made it authentic. But if you have other food that you're eating, let us know tonight. We want you to type that in the chat now and let us know that you're here with us for the evening.
I'm seeing some great meals, including ice cream, which would be my personal favorite meal. Yeah. Absolutely. Just so you know, if you want to chat with everyone, you'll see a little blue little button that in the chat that has a little drop down, and if you select panelists, then it just comes to me, Todd, and Marcus. If you select panelists and attendees, then you'll get to chat with everybody. So go ahead and select panelists and attendees, unless you have some private criticism of me, and then just select panelists, because we don't need everybody to see that. But on that note, I would ask you to be patient with us. We're learning this as we go. This is a new thing for us. So if there's any mistakes or mishaps, we apologize in advance. And just like everything else that's happened in the past year, with all of the disappointments and surprises and changes, that this night looks different. But we're glad that we can do things like this, where we can still capture a little bit of what makes being a part of this church family so special. In the past summer, our youth music tours and youth missions weren't able to happen. And we're not really sure what the summer is going to look like yet either. But we do know that one day we will be sending our youth back out into the world as representatives of this gracious church family. If you would like to donate to that cause, we are going to put up on the screen ways that you can give. You can give online by using the link that you see on your screen. We'll also put it in the chat for you. Just select the Youth Talent Show from the drop-down menu and enter the amount you'd like to give, and that way we make sure that it gets to the right place. You can also mail in a check to the church at the address listed on your screen. Just be sure to write Youth Talent Show in the memo line.
We are almost ready to begin with our talent acts, but first up, we have a message from our lead pastor, Pastor Laura Catherine Stern. Let's take a look.
Good evening. My name is Laura Catherine, and I serve as the lead pastor here at Apex, and it is my joy to welcome you to this virtual talent show tonight. Let us begin in prayer. Dear God, we give thanks for this opportunity to gather virtually, to be able to sit in our homes and see the wealth of talent that you have given to our children, to see the celebration of their gifts, to be able to see singing and performances and know that you are a God whose gifts are varied and beautiful and wonderful. Be with us this evening, this time of fellowship and fun, that we might be in praise to you. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Laura Catherine, for that message. And now it is time to begin our talent show. Our first performer for the evening is Corinne White. Corinne is a senior at Panther Creek High School. Her school activities, she doesn't do much. Let me just name the couple things she does. Cross country, winter track, track and field, theater, Latin club, Marvel club, art, book club, National Honor Society, and Key Club. So she's not a very busy person at all, very simple. Her church involvement, things that she does here include youth choir, youth group, the Apex Outreach Service Project, and she volunteers in the nursery. And she also has some hobbies aside from all those things, if you can believe that, and that includes singing, cello, drawing, writing, reading, and football. I'm exhausted, Corinne. Good for you for doing all those things. Tonight, Corinne is going to be sharing a solo with us. She'll be singing Rise Up, which is an awesome song, originally sung by Andre Day, and we're excited to share it with you. Here is Corinne White.
You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter. But I see it in you, so we're gonna walk it out. Move mountains, we're gonna walk it out. Move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up. And I'll do it a thousand times again. I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, and I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Move mountains, bring it to its feet, and move mountains. I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you. I'll rise up I will rise 1,000 times again. And we'll rise up high like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up and we'll do it 1,000 times again. For you.
Bravo. We even have a applause. This is great. Didn't you do an awesome job? That is such a great song and such a great rendition of that, Corinne. Well done. We would love for you to share your accolades in the chat. You have already seen that so much, but our youth are watching tonight live. So I know that they would really appreciate your encouragement this evening as you express your love and thanks for them in this virtual format.
In a normal year, our lovely MC Greg Coley would have surprises for you guys to win as part of the evening's festivities. And we still wanted to give y'all a chance to win some prizes by answering some trivia questions. But since you guys are all on your electronic devices watching us, it would very quickly turn into a game of who could type or use Siri the fastest, and that wouldn't be any fun. The trivia questions tonight will be about Marcus, Todd, and me. And you can't Google the answers to those because, well, we're just not that Google worthy. But you can try. Use the chat feature of the side and try and answer the questions. Either the first person to either answer correctly, most correctly, or if it comes to it, just make us laugh the most, will win. We'll give you time to think about it and answer over the next few acts, and then we'll announce the winner and ask the next question. And the first question tonight is going to be about me. What did I want to be? What was my dream job when I graduated from college? So you have the next few acts to answer, have at it, and now back to the talent.
I would like to go ahead and log my guess. It was the host of a virtual talent show. I think that was your dream job.
Yeah. I can quit now. I've peaked. I've done everything.
Yep. It's all downhill from here, Dana. Yep. Put all those good guesses in the chat. We'll get to those. But now it's time for our next talent performer. It is Joshua Fields. Joshua is a freshman at Apex Friendship High School, and he participates in the Technology Student Association. Here at Apex UMC, he's an active member of our youth handbell choir, and in his free time, he enjoys Hapkido. Tonight, Josh is going to be playing a piano solo, and it is titled I Am the Doctor by Murray Gold. So let's enjoy Joshua Fields.
Thank you.
Applause, applause. That was great, Josh. Awesome, awesome. I like how we call him Little Josh Fields in the chat. Yeah, yeah, I think he really appreciates that, y'all. Way to go, way to go. Good job, Josh, that was awesome. Share your praise, that's fantastic. It is now time to get our next performer. Performer number three is Paige Bowie. Paige is a sophomore at Apex High School, and she participates in the Academy of Information Technology and the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. At Apex UMC, Paige is active in both youth choir and her youth small group. Paige loves all forms of dance, ballet, tap, jazz, contemporary, and Scottish Highland dance. She also enjoys singing and playing the ukulele. I wonder if she can do all three at the same time. That would be something. But for tonight, Paige is going to share with us a tap dance routine, and she's going to be dancing to a great song, Stand By Me, which was recorded by Ben E. King. So without further ado, here is Paige Bowie.
Great, Paige. Thank you so much for sharing that. And I love that three acts in, we've already seen three different talents. And you're going to get more of that tonight. I wanted to comment on these, the answers about what I wanted to be when I graduated college. There's some interesting stuff in there. we'll get to that later. But for now, I wanted to share something with you guys. For the past 5 years, this talent show has raised money to support our youth missions and our youth music tours. And while we're not sure if we're going to be able to do that this summer, we do know that eventually we will be going back out there. So last year, we had an opportunity to interview some of our youth who've participated in these opportunities about what those experiences have meant to them. Keep in mind as you watch these that whatever grade they say that they're in these videos, they're now a year older and they look older too. It's kind of sad, but just so you know, so that they don't get offended and think that, you know, we're still trying to make them stay the age they were last year. But we wanted you guys to be able to see these and understand what any of the money that we raised tonight is going for. And here they are to talk about YES, our middle school mission weekend that usually happens in September, and what it means to them.
My name is Clara Griggs, and I'm a freshman at Apex High School.
Hi, my name is Noah Wallace, and I'm in seventh grade, and I go to Westlake Middle School.
I have done YES for 3 years.
I've done YES for 2 years.
YES is for middle schoolers, and you spend the nights at the church, and you go out on Saturday and do a service project, whether it be in a thrift store, a car wash, or Western Wake, and it stands for Youth Engaged in Service. It's just a bunch of middle schoolers going out, doing service projects, coming back to the church, and spending the night.
I signed up for YES because I wanted to help serve the community outside the church. It really makes an impact for the community and helps a lot of people.
The thing I enjoyed most about YES was doing the service projects and feeling the sense of community. I have really gotten to know my peers and especially my youth group better by doing YES because there's just so much bonding time because you're spending the night. People should support YES because it really invests the kids in the church. You get to know the other adults, your leaders, and the other kids that are doing it, which will make you want to come back. Thank you for supporting YES.
Thank you for supporting YES.
It's so good to see all those faces, and one day we'll all be together again and serving, one day. Hey, it's time for another talent act. Let's do it. Next up, we have Eliza Ayers performing for us. Eliza is a sophomore at Apex High School. She participates in marching band, concert band, and a variety of other clubs. At Apex UMC, Eliza participates in our youth handball choir, our youth choir, and youth group. In her spare time, she enjoys playing the guitar, swimming, climbing, and reading. Tonight, Eliza is going to be playing the flute for us, and her piece is entitled Andalus, and it's composed by Emile Pissard. So let's enjoy together Eliza Ayers.
Thank you.
That was great, Eliza. I played the flute. I saw some people talking about being flute players. I played the flute for 2 weeks one summer. That was it. That was great, Eliza. And now it's time to announce our first winner. The question was, what did I want to, or what was my dream job when I graduated from college? So I see that some of you did try to do some Googling and saw what my major was. And Jacqueline Schechter would be disqualified anyway because she has inside information because she was there with me at Carolina and we had some of the same classes. And she also was an anthropology major with me for a while. None of you, you kind of were adjacent, but nobody got it. So I'm going to go with the one that made me laugh the most. And that would be I believe that was the Finches, the tall lady in the circus. I don't know that that necessarily was my dream job when I graduated, but it definitely would have been my dream job now. what I really wanted to do was I wanted to be a curator of collections at the Smithsonian Museum of American History. So congratulations to the Finches. You guys have won a $25 gift card to a business downtown. And our next question is going to be about Marcus. If Marcus could eat only one food for the rest of his life, what would it be? You have the next few acts to answer, and the first person to answer correctly or close to correctly or to make us laugh will win a fabulous prize.
What food would Marcus eat for the rest of his life? Interesting. I can't wait to see these responses. Hey, guess what? It's time for another talent act. Woohoo! Our next act is two performers. It's a duet and it's my brothers, Caden and Kale White. So let me start with Caden. Caden is a sophomore at Green Level High School and he is involved in theater, football, and band. At church, Caden participates in youth handbells, youth choir, youth group, and the Apex Outreach Service Project, which we'll hear more about in just a bit. Caden's hobby is sleeping. Caden, I really like that hobby. I would like to take that hobby on myself. Great one. And he will be joined in his talent by his brother, Kale. Kale is a seventh grader at Moore Square Magnet Middle School, and he participates in the orchestra, theater, the D&D club, Odyssey of the Mind, and the book club. And in his spare time, Kale enjoys reading, art, and gaming. Caden and Kale will be singing a duet titled What Is This Feeling from the Broadway musical Wicked. So let me set it up for you. If you've never seen this musical, this song, What Is This Feeling, is sung by two roommates who don't exactly get along when the song is sung. So it'll be interesting to see how this song translates to two brothers who have been living together in a pandemic for 11 months. With that in mind, let's enjoy this performance from Caden and Kale White.
My dearest, darlingest, Momsy and Popsicle.
My dear father.
There's been some confusion over rooming here at Shiz, but of course I'll care for Nessa.
But of course I'll rise above it.
For I know that's how you'd want me to respond. Yes. There's been some confusion, for you see, my roommate is
unusually and exceedingly peculiar, and altogether quite impossible to describe.
Blonde.
What is this feeling so sudden and new?
I felt the moment I laid eyes on you.
My pulse is rushing.
My head is reeling.
My face is flushing.
What is this feeling? Fervid as a flame. Does it have a name? Yes. Loathing. Unadulterated loathing.
Your
voice.
Clothing.
Let's just say, I loathe it all. Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl with simple, utter loathing.
there's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation. It's so pure and so strong, though I do admit it came on fast. Still, I do believe that it can last, and I will be loathing, loathing you my whole life long.
Dear Glinda, you are just too good. How do you stand it? I don't think I could. She's a terror, she's a tartar. We don't mean to show a bias, but Glinda, you're a martyr.
Well, these things are said to try us.
Poor Glinda forced to resign. Someone so disgusting, if I, we just want to tell you, we're all on your side. We share your loathing.
What is this feeling so sudden? I felt the moment I laid eyes on you. My pulse is rushing, my head is reeling. Oh, what is this feeling? Does it have a name? Yes, loathing. There's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation. It's so pure and so strong. Still, I do believe that it can last, and I will be loathing forever, loathing to be deeply loathing you my whole life long.
Boom.
Awesome, guys, and good luck living together through the rest of this pandemic. Give them some love in the chat. That is fantastic. And we're going to keep the show going with another performer. Next up is Kira Casa. Kira is a sixth grader at Apex Middle School. So this is her very first talent show performance with us. So we're so excited to have her. Sixth grader at Apex Middle School. She participates in both band and theater. She is a member of the Apex UMC Youth Choir, and in her free time, Kira enjoys cooking and sewing. Kira will be sharing a piano solo that will be very familiar to everyone. This is Ode to Joy, the famous melody from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. So let's welcome at the piano, Kira Casa. Good job, Kira. Over to Dana.
Great job, Kira. That was awesome. I love Ode to Joy. So the answers, I have to tell you, these answers to what Marcus would eat for the rest of his life are pretty good. We've been especially tickled with the blood of his enemies and Excel spreadsheets, which if anybody has worked with Marcus in any capacity at all, you know that Marcus loves himself a good spreadsheet. So yeah, we're enjoying these. So keep the answers coming. You still got some time. And in the meantime, we have another video for you guys to watch. The last video was about our mission project for middle schoolers. This is going to be about AOSP. or the Apex Outreach Service Project. For over 20 years, or well, exactly 20 years, last year would have been the 21st. It's gone through different changes, but right now it is a week-long experience for high schoolers to work in the local community, making homes warmer, safer, and drier. So when you donate tonight, you'll be helping to support AOSP. Check out this video and hear what our youth have to say about it.
Hi, my name is Corinne White, and I'm an 11th grader, yikes, at Panther Creek High School.
My name is Clara Griggs, and I'm a freshman at Apex High School.
Hi, I'm Josh. I'm in 11th grade at Middle Creek High School. I've been part of AOSP for 4 years.
I have done AOSP for 4 years.
I have done AOSP 1 year. Participated in AOSP 1 year. I've helped out with it 5 years.
AOSP is Apex Outreach Service Project, and we go out into the community and we go to homes that the people can't necessarily afford to get help, or they just aren't getting help that they need. And so we go out and we help them, and we could become part of their family for a week.
Our motto is we try and make homes safer, warmer, and drier for people in our own neighborhood, because there are people nearby who need our help just as much as people overseas.
I personally really enjoy it because it's like being away from home, but I'm still at home and I get to make a difference in my own community.
Oh, I love everything about it. I love getting to meet new people. AOSP does a really great job of mixing groups together, because it's a lot more fun when you're getting to know people in this experience as well. And I also just, I like helping people. And fixing houses is something that it's really cool, helps you learn life skills, and you get to have fun with it at the same time.
I enjoyed the sense of community that I got from everybody during AOSP, because you're all stuck at the church together for a week and you really get to know each other.
I feel like being part of AOSP has taught me to look for friends in the least expected places.
I have grown as a person from being part of AOSP, not only in my relationships with my friends and with random strangers, but also in my relationship with God. Being part of AOSP has helped me realize how important it is to have relationships with people, and how that can affect your life as a Christian. And I just love going every year, meeting new friends, meeting the same ones, and getting to share the love of Jesus throughout my neighborhood here.
AOSP reaches so many more youth than anything else the church does. Even kids who don't regularly go to youth or Sunday school or church in the morning go to AOSP. And they see how fun youth is, and then they'll come to youth regularly. And it's just more people, more spreading of God's love. Thank you for supporting AOSP.
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 Thank you for supporting AOSP. Is that what I was supposed to say? Oops.
Whatever.
Whatever. We're just making this up at this point. AOSP! We're going to get that again, too. So great to see that. Okay, hey, time for another performance. Next up is another sixth grader, Ella Gray London. Her first talent show as well. Ella Gray is in middle school at Apex Middle School. She participates in band. Here at Apex UMC, Ella Gray is involved in both handbells and choir. And in her spare time, Ella Gray loves to dance. So guess what? We're gonna see another dance. Ella Gray is gonna be sharing a contemporary routine to the song You Say by Lauren Daigle, which is such a great song. Just so you know, this is a routine, this routine was choreographed by Taylor Derenbacher, and it was videoed last March. In a competition prior to the pandemic shutdown. So you're gonna see people gathered together, you know, things we don't actually get to do these days. So don't be freaked out by that. It was before the shutdown. But we are so excited to welcome Ella Gray to our talent show and have her perform her dance routine to You Say. Let's check it out now.
Keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.
That was awesome.
That was amazing. I think that the Finches said something that I think it was the Finches. Somebody said I could dance like that if I wanted to, but then I'd be in the hospital. I feel that same way. That was absolutely beautiful. So we've got another fabulous prize to give away. The last question that we asked you was if Marcus could eat any food, or had to eat any food for the rest of his life, what food would he pick? And then we got some really amazing answers. The answer is actually pizza, which, yeah, big surprise, right? That the youth director would choose pizza. But I have to give Marcus props, because pizza can be so many things. There's like breakfast pizza, there's dessert pizza. So I think it's a pretty safe choice. If you could only eat one thing for the rest of your life, then you can just all kinds of different options for that. So good choice. So Lee Reddick was our winner for that one. So congratulations, Lee. You'll be getting a $25 gift card to a downtown business. And now we have one last chance to win a fabulous prize. So this question is my favorite of the evening. This question is about Todd. So what did Todd want to be when he grew up? You have the next few acts to answer in the chat, and the first person to answer correctly or close to correctly, or however we feel like, whichever one we want to give it to, then we'll win another gift card to a downtown business. So start answering, and back to the talent.
I can't wait to see what these answers come out, Dana.
Oh, they're already pretty good.
Yeah, I know. Here we go. Okay, it's time for another performer. Dun, 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 dun. Lily Griffin is up next. Lily is an eighth grader at Apex Friendship Middle School, where she participates in band and track and field. Here at Apex UMC, Lily is involved in youth group, and she volunteers for our children's ministry, where her mother is the director. So I don't know if she has a choice in volunteering or not, but she's an excellent volunteer. So thank you, Lily. And in her spare time, Lily enjoys a variety of dance, including ballet, point, jazz, modern. She enjoys drawing, and she also loves a good Chick-fil-A milkshake. So do I, Lily. Great choice. Tonight, Lily is going to be playing the flute for us, and she's going to be playing Lord of the Dance. So here we go. This is Lily Griffin. Great job, Lily. Give her some love.
That was great, Lily. Thank you for sharing your talent with us. Again, I played flute for 2 weeks. So, yeah, I'm impressed.
I'm sure it was a great 2 weeks, though, Dana.
Well, yeah.
Hey, we have a treat. After this next talent act, Dana's going to pull her flute out and she's going to play for us. Yeah. Thank you, Dana.
Anyone? Well, I play the radio. That's about as good as I get.
Dana, you have a year to prepare. Next year, we want a flute solo.
That's right.
Tonight, we have been blessed by so many talents of our youth. And many of these youth that you see performing are a part of our youth music ministries, either a part of our hymnal choir or our youth choir or both. Our choirs have had the opportunity to share their musical talents for the past several years as part of our annual youth choir tours. We have visited such places as Charleston, Charlotte, Atlanta, and Richmond. And this past year, we were scheduled to go to England until the pandemic had other plans for us, sadly. We're not sure what this summer holds, of course, as we're seeing how things go and trying to be safe, but we do know that one day, again, our youth will travel and we will be able to share our music with those who need it around our community. So we have a video to show you about here, some of our youth and what they had to say about what these experiences mean for them. Let's take a look.
My name is Abby Cameron. I go to Thales Academy, Apex High School.
Hi, I'm Josh. I'm in 11th grade at Middle Creek High School.
Hi, my name is Noah Wallace, and I'm in 7th grade, and I go to Westlake Middle School.
Hi, my name is Corinne White, and I'm an 11th grader, yikes, at Panther Creek High School.
My name is Clara Griggs, and I'm a freshman at Apex High School. I've gone on the choir tour 3 years.
This will be my third year doing choir tour.
I've been a part of the youth choir for 2 years.
I've done the choir tour for 4 years.
So the choir tour is a chance for the choir to go around to other churches and perform for people to spread our knowledge of God and our musical abilities. We've been to Georgia, we've been to South Carolina and Richmond, and we like to just like spread the word of God and be there for other people. Oftentimes I've had people come up to me and like tell me how much of an impact they've had just by us being there for them.
This year is a little bit different. We are going to England this year, and we're going to sing for the people in England, and we're gonna get to travel and study John Wesley. My favorite part of choir tour is probably all of the unexpected things that come along. Whether it's your bus breaks down and you're singing at a rest stop, or just all the fun little moments in between where you're talking to maybe somebody at a retirement home that you were singing at and you get to hear their stories.
Music can touch people more than just a regular sermon can. Frankly, I can get bored just listening to people talk, but if it's like seeing someone sing or play handbells, it's a lot more engaging. And especially in the retirement communities, when some of the people that were playing for are older, they've forgotten everything, But when they hear some of the old hymns, like "The Old Rugged Cross," "How Great Thou Art," they'll start singing along with us. And that can just reach so many more people than someone standing up there and talking. It was my first choir tour. I was in sixth grade. And coming back from Charleston, our bus broke down at a rest stop. So we decided to just haul out all the bells and Facebook Live a concert. And we were just standing there at the rest stop playing our little bells. And people who were just using the rest stop normally would come and they would watch us. And it was a lot funner than it sounds.
I have benefited quite a lot from being part of choir. First of all, I don't actually know how to read music, so that's a first starter. it's definitely the best way to learn a new skill is to be thrown into it and do your best from there. Also, I've grown as a person in the church. I love getting to be a part of the service and getting to share our beautiful voices with the rest of the congregation.
It spreads joy to so many people, and music affects people really deeply.
Thank you for supporting the choir tour.
Thank you for supporting the choir tour.
Thank you for supporting the choir tour.
Thank you for supporting the choir tours.
Thank you for supporting the choir tour.
So great to see those faces. One day we'll sing and ring together again, guys. Thank y'all for sharing that. Time for our next performance. This is a duo of seniors. So this is their last talent show with us, sadly, but it is Megan Parks and Joshua Wallace. So let me tell you about Megan first. She is a senior at Grace Christian School. At Apex UMC, she serves on the worship team. And in her free time, she enjoys being involved in theater and dance. And then Joshua Wallace is a senior at Middle Creek High School. He volunteers with Red Cross there. At Apex, here he participates in youth praise band, youth choir, and youth handbells. And in his spare time, Josh enjoys competitive cheer and piano. Tonight, Megan is going to be singing the solo "Truth I'm Standing On." This is originally recorded by Leanna Crawford, and Josh is going to be accompanying her on the piano. So again, they're both seniors, so this is their last talent show, but we're excited to get one more performance from them before they graduate and go on with their lives. So let's welcome Megan Parks and Joshua Wallace.
Thank you.
Bravo, bravo. Great job, seniors. We are going to miss both of you, but that was awesome. Thanks for being in our talent show for so many years and this one last year. Okay, there's still time to answer the question, what did I want to be when I grew up? I don't know. You've got one more talent act to get those answers in, and then Dana's going to share who gets the prize. But now it's time for our last act of the night. We have made it to the end, sadly, but we have a great one for you here. It's Anna Duval. Anna is an eighth grader at Apex Friendship Middle School. She's a member of the basketball and soccer teams, and she also participates in Equity Club, Band, and the National Junior Honor Society. Here at Apex UMC, Anna is part of our youth choir and youth group, and in her free time, she enjoys playing the piano and baking. Anna is going to play the clarinet for us this evening. She's accompanied by her mom, Heather Duval, on piano, and Anna's piece is titled Spinning Song by composer Albert Ehrenreich. So let's give a warm welcome for Anna Duval. Was awesome. And your mom did okay too, but you were the star there. Nice job. Don't we have just the best youth ever? Isn't this amazing? I love this night so much that we get to see these youth perform in this way and get to share the things that they do and love. It was such a good night and so cool to still do it virtually. So yay for them.
Yes. Oh, this was so great. I hate that we're at the end of our talent, but what an amazing lineup we had. And thank you to all of our youth who shared their talents with us tonight. And thank you all for being here. Before we close tonight, we have one last fabulous prize to give away. Earlier, we asked you what Todd wanted to be when he grew up. His mother did answer correctly, but that does not count. Although she was beaten to it by Bill Bass. I am amazed that anybody got this correctly, and it makes me wonder if Todd's just been going around telling people this for years and I just hadn't heard it. But the correct answer is that Todd wanted to be a game show host. So congratulations to Bill. You have won a $25 gift card to a business downtown. Now, I have it on good authority that Todd still dreams of one day being a game show host when he grows up. So how did he do, y'all? Can you imagine him taking over for Pat Sajak? Thank you.
I have a new appreciation for Pat Sajak after tonight. I want to change my answer.
Okay.
I want to be Vanna. I don't have to say anything. Can I do that?
Well, thank you all for letting Todd kill his dream tonight. and try to be a game show host. We appreciate you. Hanging in there with us for that.
Yep. Thanks, guys. We appreciate it. Dana, can't wait to see you perform as the tall lady in the circus too. You just let us know when that's happening.
Yeah, I'm working on that.
We'll be there to support you all the way, Dana. We're here for you. Oh, we've had such a great night. This is so fun. It's been so fun to see you all in the chat, even though we can't see you in person. This has been a great way to connect. So we're thankful for that you joined us tonight. And don't forget, we love donations to keep supporting these wonderful youth and these wonderful opportunities that they will have for years to come. All of these opportunities they have are just so amazing. And we're so grateful for your support that you have given over the years for this. So if you'd like to donate, we're going to put up on the screen in just a second that slide one more time. You can go to the website and go, I think it's aumc.org/giving. And under the drop-down menu, choose a youth talent show and your funds will go there. Or if you're the old-fashioned way, you want to write out a check and send to us, that's great too. You can do that. Yep, there's all the information you have you need on the screen. We're so grateful and appreciate your generosity. And yeah, I think that's all. Dana, you want to go have a drink or something?
Are we allowed to say that?
Oh, are we allowed to say, goodbye, goodbye.
Thank you all for joining us. Yeah, we're going to need the next week off to recover.
Yep. So Greg Culley, we look forward to having you back next year, Greg Culley.
Yes, please.
Please, Greg, come back. Okay,
thank you guys.
Everybody, have a great night.